Kevin Gates has had a long history in the hip hop space with hit songs like Really Really, Change Lanes, and Two Phones, which has all hit billboards
and gets an average of 4 million Spotify plays each month. But Kevin Gates has had an even longer history with the law, with charges like aggravated assault, robbery, and grand theft auto. This is Top Trend TV,
and today we'll be talking about the criminal history of Kevin Gates. Kevin was born on February 5th, 1986, in New Orleans, but later moved to Baton Rouge, where his criminal background started very early in his life, only at the age of 13, for stealing and another time for joyriding as a passenger.
We're in Southside Baton Rouge, in the bottom, we're going to the club here tonight.
He says in a Vladtv interview, he gravitated toward a lot of individuals that were doing the wrong things with the right intentions. Meaning to me, he always wanted to excel in life, but didn't have the right people around him. Another early time he's been arrested was at 15 for aggravated assault. Unsure of the details, but this was the first time that he was charged and did a little over 2 years in juvenile hall. Kevin says the time he did took the fear of imprisonment away and criminalized him at an early age. Soon after being released, at 17, Kevin got into an altercation with a guy outside of a movie theater and ended up stabbing him in self-defense, but him already being a convicted felon made it harder on his part. So he went back to jail a day after Christmas.
After being released for the stabbing altercation, Kevin ended up getting pulled over. When the police searched his vehicle, they found a gun around a controlled and dangerous substance. The repeated charges caught up with him, and the judge was really not on his side fighting for his case. So the judge gave him a sentence revolving two separate charges, choosing not to run them as concurrent offenses. Which means instead of doing just 15 years for both charges, he would do 30 for both charges.
But when I went to jail, it was for being a convicted felon already in possession of a firearm around a controlled dangerous substance, which is drugs. Well, the law is, if it's your first offense with a weapon, it's 5 years. If you're a convicted felon with a firearm, that's 10 to 15. So while in court, you know, my history, I have a prior history, which most individuals that come from an impoverished environment will have a prior criminal record, you know, criminal history. And they use that and say, well, you know, we can't hit you with the Habitual Offender Act, but you're on your way to be a career criminal. Let's give him 30.
You know that. Gates only ended up doing about 3 years in prison. During this time, he stayed involved in mentorship groups and giving back to the younger generation. Time Kevin did, he learned how to treat others with respect, saying at the beginning of interviews,
"The penitentiary rules in effect."
Meaning he will respect everything and everyone around him, as long as he is given the same respect. Kevin is known to be one of the realest in the game, for just the way how he talks and carries himself, and his music speaks for itself.
What up, world? Hello, world. Street Cred Magazine, I'm kicking it right now. And my name Kevin Gates, and I'm the man down here, and I'm in demand down here. I'm like one of the hottest niggas out here right now. Like, I'm clicking the chrome, click on the dome of the long smith and the snippet, your long whiskers. You a rat. I know it's not, but I'm making it your business. Feeding them kids chickens to getting your biscuits, hey. Ain't nothing sicker, unzipping this prick zipper. He pull out his skeet leaker, get ripped with a meat cleaver. I'm from the slums, I'm known as a young gun. I'm grown in the gun pumper, so suck on a nice Nina. Your girl is known as a young nothing. I call her a dumb plumber, stop hugging.
The charge that he faced, other than the stabbing altercation, each had drug elements in connection with it. In addition, sources state that Gates was arrested for traveling without permission from a Louisiana court order causing a violation of his previous offenses. He stated during an interview with This Is 50 that he did an additional 3 months in the beginning of 2014.
In 2016, Kevin was found guilty for misdemeanor battery, and was sentenced to 180 days in jail. The incident in question occurred at an August 2015 concert at Rumors Nightclub in Lakeland, Florida, where Gates was recorded kicking a 19-year-old audience member in the chest while on stage. The widely circulated footage was used as evidence in the case, along with Dixon's testimony. Previously, Gates has publicly argued his incident, claiming that Miss Dixon grabbed his shorts multiple times without his permission, and that he acted in self-defense. Miss Dixon claimed in court that she fell back and blacked out after Gates kicked her. The judge ordered 1 year probation and jail time. In 2017, Kevin got sentenced to 30 months in jail for a gun charge. The warrant for the charge was old. It was made in Illinois in 2013. Kevin actually just avoided the state from there on, and later cleared things up with his legal team and just turned himself in. Other than Kevin's long history with the law, Kevin married his longtime girlfriend in 2015 and later on had two kids with her. Kevin has made hints in the past that he has other kids with other females, but that is untrue of today. Ever since Kevin was released in 2017, he has had no more legal issues. Remember to like, comment, and subscribe if you like this content and want to see more like it. Comment down below if you have any suggestions on who you want to see next or any ideas for the channel that could help.